Many recent computational photography techniques rely on accurate depth maps, yet there are no easy tools that allow artists to make changes or corrections to them. One could argue that these depth-based edits could be achieved using popular conventional photo editing applications. While it is possible, it does not take into account the geometry and structure of objects in the scene, and does not provide a real-time 3D visualizer to see the effects, thereby making the editing process harder and longer. We present a lightweight interactive depth editing tool that uses conventional image editing operations for geometric manipulation of the depth scene. This allows us to make local and global adjustments to the depth map and display the resulting 3D structure in real time, making the editing process easy and fast. To demo how this depth editing tool works, we will edit the default sample images available on our web application.
This application comes preloaded with an RGB image and a depth image. We also have the option to load your own RGB image and depth image from the file menu. The editing process is broken down into layers, where each of these layers will contain our depth selections, so we can perform edits independently. So I'll select the first layer over here. Before we start editing, let's visualize our 3D visualization of our depth map, so we can see the incorrect depth in our image. So far, you can see the incorrect depth of the faces, this and every other face here, so we'll try to fix them. Also, if I zoom out a bit, you can see the incorrect position of the trees. We also need to fix that. So the first step to do is to make our selections. This application comes with a select option here, where you can use to select the different parts of our depth map. So I'm just going to select the faces. I'll start with this one over here. Once we've drawn our bounding box, we can use the histogram of depth values to make fast segmentations. So now I've selected this, I can add it to our layer. I'll do the same for the other faces. So I'm just going to change the layer and draw it in again. Now I've drawn the drawing box, I can make our selection using the histogram depth values. I'll do the same for the other faces in this image. Select the face and segment it using the histogram of depth values. I'll just add on the layer to select the people at the back. Then I can draw my bounding box and then make my selection and add to the layer. Like I mentioned, I also need to select the trees since they need to be corrected. Adjust it and add to the layer. I also want to select the second tree in this particular layer, so the application comes with a multiple selection here. The other options, which is the subtract from selection and intersect selection. So I'm just going to add multiple selections so I can add the second tree to this particular layer. So I'm just going to draw my bounding box again and then adjust my histogram, my depth values using the histogram, and add it to the layer. Okay, now I'm done making my selections. Next, I'll start making my edits. I'll start with the first image here and then zoom in a bit so we can see the edits in real time. In order to fix this, I just need to adjust the depth details using the slider over here. So I'm just going to adjust it so you can see the effects immediately. So I guess this should be fine for this. I also need to do the same for the other faces in this image. I'll do it for the second person here. And yeah, looks better than it was. Then I'll also fix the next face by adjusting it. Yeah, this looks fine. I also need to do the same for the other people at the back, which I selected. So I'll just reduce the depth details once more. So it looks okay. Now I need to fix the trees at the back. So realistically, these trees are meant to be straight, so we can have to do two things. The first one is reduce the depth details to make it flatter than it is. And once I'm done with this, I'm just going to push the tree a bit backward. So in order to do this, I have the depth intensity slider, where if I push it, if I increase the value, it takes it further. And if I reduce it, it takes it towards the back. So I'm just going to take it a bit back, but close to. Then, yeah, so I guess this is fine. So now I'm done with my edits. The application allows you to save and export the depth image by clicking here in the file menu. You can also download your selections in case you intend to reload them back later. Now that we are done editing, let's look at our final results and make comparison. We can also see the result using the Ken Burns effect.
Monocular depth estimation is becoming an important tool of structure-aware computational photography approaches. Our open-source lightweight interactive tool is the first step in integrating depth map manipulation in traditional photo editing pipelines. Thanks for watching.